The iPhone turns 10 year. Happy birthday. In that video, you are going to discover 10 ways Apple changed the world with its iPhone. On June 29, 2007, the iPhone went on sale for the first time. Although many derided it as a probable flop, the handset, and the other smartphones that followed, changed the world in a way that few gadgets have done before. First, the GPS. Before the days of GPS on your phone, if you weren't sure where you were, you'd have to look for a map, or worse, ask a stranger. Even original iPhone didn't have location services, that wasn't included until the iPhone 3G the following year, and it wasn't the first GPS phone either. But imagine calling an Uber without it now. Simply impossible. In second, threaded text messages. This may be impossible to remember, but before the iPhone's threaded message interface, texts were stored as individual files within a menu. You'd have to open each one individually and go back and forth between them to look back through a conversation. The Messages app changed it by displaying texts on one screen, saving you invaluable seconds. Third, selfies. We will leave judgments about their value, but the selfie has undoubtedly been a social phenomenon brought on by front-facing cameras on smartphones. Front-facing cameras appeared on phones as early as 2003, and when they made it to the iPhone 4, people thought they would be for video calls. The selfie craze sprang up by itself, rather than because of any design decision. Fourth, batteries that only last a day. Remember when your old Nokia would last for 5 days, even after playing Snake all day? There's no chance of that these days. The array of sensors and processes on modern smartphones mean batteries are under constant strain. A decade after the iPhone was launched, battery life has barely moved on, meaning a whole industry of accessories such as the above have emerged. Fifth, the iPhone has killed the phone call. Mobile phones, all phones in fact, used to be for phone calls. Now it's so easy to text, email or tweet that we barely bother to ring people. A study in 2015 showed that a quarter of smartphone owners had not used it to make a call in the last week. Not to mention voicemail, which has all but died out. In sixth, autocorrect feature. The touchscreen killed the physical keyboard for good, but replaced it with the horror of autocorrect. Autocorrect fails have become a part of everyday life, although this might not be the case forever. Apple has patented software that would show users when messages had been corrected. Seventh, pub quizzes and arguments are ruined. Anytime you don't know the answer to something, you can now whip out your phone. This is obviously great for many reasons, train timetables, word translations, but there was something to not knowing. Arguments are now instantly over, which may or may not be a good thing. And when you come second in a pub quiz, you'll always have the lingering suspicion that the other team cheated. 8th, the pinch to zoom feature. One of the common problems with mobile phones before the iPhone was that their screens seemed too small to do anything on. That's where pinch to zoom came in. It is now such a widespread gesture, and one that exists in so many places, that kids will now try it on almost anything, whether it has a touch screen or not. In ninth position, the applications aka the apps. It's a word that barely existed a decade ago but is now an industry worth tens of billions of pounds. The humble app is behind the success of the iPhone and has spawned hundreds of major companies from Instagram to Uber. The App Store arrived on the iPhone 3G in 2008. There are now over 2 million apps, and people spent about $23 billion on iOS apps last year. To conclude this top 10, we have the death of the iPod. Before the iPhone, we all used to carry around an MP3 player as well as a phone, and maybe a digital camera too. In 2009, Apple sold around 55 million iPods. But every iPhone sold was another iPod not needed. Apple still sells them, but they haven't been updated in years. Now that the iPhone has just turned 10 years, what do you think about the evolution of the iPhone during this decade? Give us your thoughts in comments. To discover more Apple and mobile related content, don't hesitate to subscribe to the S. Sorrells channel.